Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, welcome to Finite Element Methods. So let us learn how to apply this method of least squares to a differential equation in the present class. In the last class, we have learned how to apply the method of least squares for some discrete data points, but that is not really required in FEM. We want to solve the differential equation. We want to solve the governing equation using the method of least squares. So let us see how to do that using this method. Let us say the differential equation of the form capital F equal to the same one I took earlier, xi ui ui prime ui double prime etc. So now here, as in the previous case, as in the point collocation, here also we will assume a trial function, a trial solution. So let us say the trial solution be, let ui tilde b sigma I is equal to 1 to n ai fi. So as in the previous case, these fi's must be independent as well as they must satisfy the boundary conditions. They must be kinematically admissible. Since this is an assumed trial solution or assumed solution, both are same, this is a trial solution, and if we substitute this trial solution in our actual governing equation, will be having some error. So the error is given as function of xi ui tilde, that is the assumed function, ui tilde prime ui tilde double prime etc., which is not equal to 0. So until now it is clear, even in the point collocation. So now the way I am going to make this error to 0 is different from the point collocation. So now I am going to make this error to 0 in the integral sense. So what I meant by integral sense is, I am going to make this error to 0 as integral mod e dx is equal to 0 or integral e power 2j into dx is equal to 0. If it is 1D case, this is 1D, and if I am taking for the 2D case, then over the integral mod e dx dy has to be 0, integral the error power 2j dx dy is equal to 0. So I can make this error to 0 in this integral sense. That is, here j can be any positive integer if j is equal to 2. That will represent method of least squares, that is analogous to the method of least squares. This case of 1D, 2D and 3D is obvious. So 3D will be integral error power 2j dv has to be 0. So this is the way I am going to make my error 0. But one more step is, I have to find out the constants. So how to find out the constants? The similar way we did for the discrete data. Now I am going to make this error 0 as dou e by dou ai has to be 0. That is, I am having a0, a1, a2, etc. up to those many constants I am having in my polynomial. So I am going to differentiate this error with respect to those constants and make it to 0. That is, I will get the number of equations is equal to the number of unknowns, the similar way I did in the discrete data case. But here the difference is, here the error is in the integral form. So now, for suppose, let us take the method of least squares case. That is, for j is equal to 2, the error is given as integral, this is e power 2j, right? That is e square d omega. Let us say the domain is omega. Omega can be 1D, 2D or 3D. Okay. So now I need to differentiate this error with respect to the constants, that equal to dou by dou ai of integral capital E square d omega, that is equal to integral 2 into e into dou E by dou AI d omega, this has to be 0. And if you observe it more clearly, and if I pull 2 outside, 2 into integral E into dou E by dou AI d omega has to be 0, where this dou E by dou AI is having some particular name that is called the weighing function. And we will learn more about these weighing functions in the Galerkin methods, very versatile method. And the application of the Galerkin method in FEM is so much. So we will learn very explicitly about these weighing methods in Galerkin approach. But as far as the expression is concerned, so this is the error and this is called the weighing functions. So these functions will vary depending on the method you choose. So this has to be 0. This is important. So this is the weighing function and this is our error. Let us solve a simple ODE using this method of least squares method. Let us take the same ODE that we took before earlier. Let ODE be u double prime minus u plus x is equal to 0. And by assuming the same trial function, let the trial function be u tilde is equal to sigma I is equal to 1, 2, 3 AI sin I pi x. That is, we are taking three terms, the same trial function and the same differential equation. U tilde is given as a1 sin pi x plus a2 sin 2 pi x plus a3 sin 3 pi x. And if you substitute this u tilde in this governing equation, then you will get the error. The error term is also same. The error is capital E is equal to, I am writing it directly, please refer to the earlier notes. The error is minus of 1 plus pi square a1 sin pi x minus of 1 plus 4 pi square a2 sin 2 pi x minus of 1 plus 9 pi square a3 sin 3 pi x plus x. This is the error. So now, according to least squares, at I is equal to 1, let us say integral e dou e by dou a1 into dx. What are the limits? 0 to 1. If you see in the previous problem, the limits, the bounds of x are 0 to 1 with boundary conditions u of 0 and u of 1 is equal to 0. Equal to 0. For I is equal to 2, it will be integral 0 to 1 capital E dou E by dou A2 into dx is equal to 0. For I is equal to 3, it is integral 0 to 1 capital E dou E by dou A3 into dx is equal to 0. So we are having three simultaneous equations for three unknowns A1, A2, A3. The way we are dealing with error is different here. So what we did in the point collocation for the same problem, we made this error to 0 at some specific points over the domain. So now we are making this error to 0 in the integral sense. That is the difference. So now, if you take the first term, that is for I is equal to 1, integral E dou E by dou A1 into dx. That is integral, what is the error? Minus of 1 plus pi square A1 sin pi x minus of 1 plus 4 pi square A2 sin 2 pi x minus of 1 plus 9 pi square A3 sin 3 pi x into, now you have to differentiate this entire expression with respect to A1. So what is the term here? There is only one term with A1. So if you differentiate this one with respect to A1, then the remaining will be minus of 1 plus pi square sin pi x dx equal to 0. So here we are having terms sin pi x into sin pi x, sin 2 pi x into sin pi x, sin 3 pi x into sin pi x. We need to know the integrals, integral value. We already know those values, right? So similarly, this is your first expression, and the second expression will be minus of 1 plus pi square a1 sin pi x minus of 1 plus 4 pi square a2 sin 2 pi x minus of 1 plus 9 pi square a3 sin 3 pi x into, so you are differentiating now with respect to a2. This is for I is equal to 2. With respect to a2, it is minus of 1 plus 4 pi square sin 2 pi x dx is 0. Similarly, for I is equal to 3, it is integral minus of 1 plus pi square a1 sin pi x minus of 1 plus 4 pi square a2 sin 2 pi x minus of 1 plus 9 pi square a3 sin 3 pi x into, the differentiation of this term with respect to a3 is minus of 1 plus 9 pi square into sin 3 pi x into dx has to be 0. So we are having three simultaneous expressions, three simultaneous integrals, and we need to solve them for a1, a2, a3. If you solve these terms, sin pi x sin into sin 2 pi x sin pi x into sin 3 pi x, they will be very easy. All of them you have learned already in your trigonometric classes. So here we will get the uncoupled equations instead of coupled equations. That is, you need not to solve some coupled set of equations, you need not to invert any matrix. You will get directly the uncoupled equations where you can calculate a1, a2 and a3. It's very simple if you solve them further. If you solve them further, you will get directly a1 from the first equation and a2 from the second equation and a3 from the third equation. So this is the way to calculate the unknowns or the solution for the differential equation using method of least squares. So remember the concept of weighing function. I will tell you about this weighing function more clearly and more elaborately in the forthcoming Galerkin approach classes, Galerkin methods classes. Thank you so much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Akidem, subscribe to Akidem.